focus is property number one, which is thermal expansion. Write down. This is a property of every substance, and it says that the substance, write down, the substance will expand, okay, substance will expand if the temperature of the substance is increased, if the temperature of the substance is increased. What will happen to a substance if the temperature is decreased? It will contract. Okay, so whatever was the situation before, it will come back to that. Fine. So this is what we are going to learn. Now, when I say expansion, what do you mean by that? Expansion is what? Expansion of length, expansion of width, expansion of area, or expansion of volume. What do you mean?
Volume. When the volume comes.
Expansion of volume. Expansion of everything, all the dimensions, each and every dimension will expand. Fine, be it length, width, area, or volume, everything will expand. Okay, so we will talk about it one by one. First, we'll take the most simplistic scenario, that is linear expansion. Okay, write down linear expansion, and in a way, you know, area is nothing but multiplication of two linear dimensions. So if linear expansion is there, volume aerial expansion is anyway there, and if aerial expansion is there, volume anyway is there. Okay, so they are interlinked. Linear expansion. So have you learned little bit about calculus? Little bit, like for example, something is varying, a curve sort of thing, then you assume a very very small interval, and then you say that in that small interval you can assume it to be linear even though it is a curve.
Yes.
Okay, similarly here, the expansion is so less, that you can assume that it changes linearly with the temperature. What I mean to say is that if you consider length, L, if this length changes by delta L for delta T increase in temperature, if you change the temperature by 2 delta T, how much will be increase in length? 2 delta L. You're getting it? So you assume it to be sequential increase or linear increase with the temperature. Fine? Now let's get into little bit more detail. Suppose I take a rod, let's say a rod has length L. Okay, you have provided heat to the rod and its temperature has changed from T naught. From T naught, its temperature has gone to T naught plus delta T. So increase in temperature is delta T. And length is increased to L plus delta L. Okay? Now can you tell me this delta L increase in the length should be proportional to what? Delta T. Immediately that will come in your mind. Delta T. It should be proportional to delta T. What else? Delta L should be proportional to what else? It should be like, it should depend on delta T, delta L should depend on material, of course, because it is a property of a material, it has to depend on what is a material, otherwise it is not a property of substance. Okay, what else? Delta L depends on what else?
The original length.
That does it depend on L also, delta L? If I take half the length, L by 2, will delta L be still the same or it will be different? If I just take L by 2 length, L by 2, okay, I divide this rod into L by 2 and L by 2. Okay, if I increase the temperature, what should be the expansion here if delta L was initial? It should be delta L by 2 here,
yeah,
and delta L by 2 there. Are you getting it? Or let me give you a simpler way to visualize. You take a rubber band and you stretch it. If shorter the rubber band, same amount of force, small extension is there. Longer the rubber band, same amount of force, longer is the extension. Getting it? Each and every part will expand. This L by 2 will expand now. So each and every part here will expand, but the total length is L by 2 right now. So total expansion will be delta L by 2. So in a way, the expansion depends on the original length also. Fine? So delta L is proportional to whatever was the initial length. Let's call it as L naught. Fine? Now, these are the two mathematical relations. Okay, so I can combine these two and I can say that delta L is proportional to L naught into delta T. I can say that. Okay, now I'll put a proportionality constant. Okay, I'll put a proportionality constant and I'll say that proportionality constant is specific to the material. So this depends on material. This thing is taken care by the constant itself. Getting your point? So delta L is equal to L naught alpha delta T, where alpha is coefficient of linear expansion. Okay. Alpha is coefficient of linear expansion. It is typically of the order of 10 raised to the minus 5. It is very, very less. And if you see the variation of alpha, let's say with temperature, this is alpha, it goes something like this. Okay, so after 500 Kelvin alpha becomes a constant. This proportionality constant alpha, even though we are treating it a constant, it doesn't remain constant at a lesser temperature. It becomes constant after 500 Kelvin or so, for a particular material itself. Okay? But then whenever we talk about thermal expansion, our temperature will be typically more than this. Okay? So until and unless specified, we will assume alpha is a constant for a given material. Any doubt? Now, using this, let's say you have a rectangular plate. You have a rectangular plate of length L and width B. Fine. You are increasing the temperature by delta T. Okay. Coefficient of linear expansion is given as alpha. Okay, initial area is what? L into B is the initial area. Find out the final area when temperature increases by delta T. Try to derive it. What will happen to L? How much?
Delta
L will be L alpha delta T. Okay, so L will increase by delta L. What will happen to B? Increase by delta B. So B will increase little bit like this. So the new rectangle will be like this. Okay, so this much is the extra area that comes in because of the expansion. Fine. I want to find out what is, you know, new area in terms of LB, alpha and delta T. Assume alpha to be very less. Should I do it? Most of you have exams going on. Like, you guys, they have exams going on, right?
For me, it's starting next week. Aim for
next week. Next week. This chapter is coming?
No.
No. Should I do it now?
The alpha square.
Yeah, you ignore it. Ignore alpha square because alpha is of the order of 10 to the minus 5.
So alpha square means
you ignore alpha square. If it is like alpha square plus alpha, you ignore alpha square. It's like adding 0.00001 with 100. Still 100. Okay, so the new length will be equal to the original length plus delta L. Any doubt here? Delta L is what? L alpha delta T. Okay, so you will get L times 1 plus alpha delta T. Right? And similarly, you can find the new width to be equal to original width 1 plus alpha delta T. Okay? So the new area is what? Length into width. Again? So the new area, new length into new width, this is equal to L into B 1 plus alpha delta T whole square. L into B is what? Original area, right? So the new area is equal to the original area, and then expand this 1 plus alpha square delta T square plus 2 alpha delta T. Okay, so this you just ignore. Alpha square is very, very less. So you will get new area is equal to the original area into 1 plus 2 alpha delta T. Fine? So it looks very similar to L is equal to L naught 1 plus alpha delta T. Okay? Or you can also write here A n minus A naught, which is delta area, change in area, is equal to A naught into 2 alpha delta T. Fine? So this formula looks very similar to delta L is equal to L naught alpha delta T. Okay? So if alpha is coefficient of linear expansion, 2 alpha should be coefficient of aerial expansion. Fine. So we can also name this constant as beta, and we say that this is equal to A naught beta delta T. Okay, where beta is equal to 2 alpha, and it is coefficient of aerial expansion. Any doubts? Nothing. Now similarly, what do you think the formula will be for volumetric expansion? Can you draw a parallel and write down the formula for volumetric expansion?
Delta V
will
be
delta V is equal to
V naught into 3 alpha.
3 alpha delta. Okay, so you not only multiply length and width, you also multiply height. So there comes 1 plus alpha delta t whole cube. So you ignore cube and square terms, and 3 alpha delta t will come. Fine. So here delta v is equal to original volume into 3 alpha delta t. This 3 alpha you can write it as gamma. So v naught gamma delta t. This gamma is coefficient of volumetric expansion. Any doubts till now? So this is the quantitative analysis of expansion. We have quantified all the formulas over here. No doubts?